Welcome, welcome, welcome back, friends. This is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and today I am here to share my tools, and that is my heat gun and my hair dryer. This is not a crafting tool, but I had used it before getting this one. So yes, I would really like to share about this, and this was requested by many of you out there. So I really hope you will like this tutorial, and I hope that I would be able to answer all your queries regarding the heat gun and the hair dryer. One very important thing, this is not a promotional video. I am not promoting any brand here. I am not promoting any hair dryer here. It is just that I have been asked many a times, and it's an obvious thing that whenever we start crafting, we don't want to spend too much of money at a go. We really want to take a slow step and then buy the supplies what we need. And I think that was the reason which actually took me so many years to buy this tool. So this is a heat gun by Ranger. I bought this last year, and trust me, I love this one. But before I got this beautiful heat gun, I used to use this one. This is a hair drying tool, a hair blower, and I used to use this for the crafting. And the main particular reason why I wanted to buy this one was to do my embossing work. But once I bought this tool, I actually realized that there is a huge difference in a blow dryer and a heat gun. So let's get started. Now, one of the very basic difference is that the amount of noise that both these tools create. So I will start with my heat gun. So I'll just switch on my heat gun, and you can hear the noise. So this is the noise what you get from your heat gun. And now I'll start this blow dryer. Okay, so as you can see, that one of the very basic point is that this makes a lot more noise than your heat gun. Now this might differ for the other brand, the blow dryers. I really don't know, because I have used one Philips, and this one, they used to make a lot of noise. This one also makes a lot of noise, and this one does not have any noise as compared to this one. So the next very important thing which I realized after getting this blow dryer is that, so in this one I had the option to have hot air, and if I switch it on and I press this button, I'm going to get cold air. So with this, so of course I really can't show you how the hot or the cold it was, but in this you just have the on and off system, and it is going to give you a really hot air. So this is quite hot. This is really hot, and if you see it clearly, it just have the off and on button. So you need to plug this to your switchboard, and you can just on it, use it, and it's done. So second difference is done. Now the third one, I would like to show you with some water. So I will take up a cardstock, and now I am going to put some water in this so that I can show you that how a blow dryer works and how a heat gun works. So here what I'm going to do is I am going to have some water here, and I'm going to make sure that I have little extra water here and some water here. Now this is just to show you the difference with how different these tools work. And okay, now in the first area I'm going to use my blow dryer, and you will see that it is going to splash. Can you see? It just splashed. I hope you can see that. Let me zoom in. Okay, can you see the watermark? It just splashed. Now I'm going to use my heat gun, and it is going to not blend in the color, blend in the water, not going to splash anything. It is just going to
dry it on that area only.
Now if you want to blend in the colors with your heat gun, you need to, supposingly if with this, if I add one color, let me add some black color to this. Okay, so here I have added some black color, and now if I use my heat gun here, it is not going to smudge too much unless until I add water to it and I rotate my base and then I use my heat gun. So can you see the smudging level is literally zero. So this is just perfect for quick drying your projects. This is just perfect for blending in your colors, and just do the natural blending, and with the heat gun you can speed up the drying process. Now if I want to color blend here, it's really easy. With a blow dryer, I had some water, I will dip in some color, and now I just need to use my blow dryer, and you will see. Oh, did you saw that? So this is what happens when you use your heat gun and when you use your blow dry. The blow dry is going to just splash the air, and this is something which has a very focal air which does not splashes your paints or anything. So this is one of the very important thing which you need to keep in mind whenever you are buying your tools, that why you need that tool, why is it important for you. And I am a believer that a good tool always helps you in creating some beautiful artwork. It saves your time and actually enhances your project. So in that way, I would really recommend you to buy a heat gun. Sorry. I would really suggest you to spend on a good quality heat gun, which is actually going to help you in creating beautiful artwork and enhancing your projects and saving your time. Now let me clean up this and then we'll start with the next important difference of these two. Now the next difference what I'm going to share this with you is one of the very important and very crucial thing. Now whenever you're working with your heat gun, it also helps in your embossing project. So here I would like to share with you all one of the very basic embossing work what you can do with your heat gun. So here I'm taking a black color cardstock. I know it's not that a great color, but this is actually going to highlight my embossing powder a little more, which will be more visible to you. So now whenever you're using your heat gun, you need a watermark stamp pads. Now what are watermark stamp pads? Watermark stamp pads are something which is transparent. When you touch it, it has something sticky. Can you see my finger? It has something shiny, and this is what sticks your embossing powder to your paper. Now here I have this stamp which says happy birthday, and now I'm going to use my watermark pad and I am going to do my embossing process here. Now this is really simple. Now here you can see my embossing color. This is just transparent, but it looks colorful because it's a dark color cardstock. And now I am going to use my clear embossing powder and I'm going to sprinkle it on my stamped image. Now you cannot do this with any other ink pads. You will need your Versamark ink pads, and once you are done with this, you need to run your heat gun on the top of it. One very important thing, you cannot use your heat gun on only one area. You need to keep it moving continuously, otherwise it is going to ruin your project. It is going to burn your base. Can you see the immediate change in this? Can you see? Now my embossing powder is clear, so whatever the stamped image is, it is going to brighten up, and I would really like to show you that this is how it looks. Now this is called the embossing effect, which can be done only with your heat gun. So your heat gun is really important for your embossing effect. I would like to show you again. So you use your VersaMark ink pad, you use the watermark ink pad, apply the stamp, and then you use your embossing powder. So the one which I have is a clear embossing powder. I love this one. And once you are done with your embossing work, take out the extra embossing powder and use your heat gun. And this is how beautiful the embossing effect gets. Now you get embossing powder in different colors and variations, but I have been using this clear one only since long. And yes, I have to buy a few more shades, which I think I will buy really soon now. And yes, here I just did my heat tool, and now it's time for the hair dryer. Now again, I'm going to repeat the same process. I'm using my Stampit. I'm doing my work, and now I am going to use my embossing powder. And once it sticks well, I am just going to take out all the extra portions here. And now I'm going to use my hair dryer, and you will see that what happens to it. So it actually blew away all my embossing powder from my paper, and this does not work at all. So if you want to do your embossing work, you need a heat gun. Your hair dry is not going to work at all. So this is one of the very important use of your heat gun tool. Now last but not the least, and one of the very basic aspects of using your heat gun and blow dryer. Now these are the very different tools. They do not have the same purpose at all, because one is used for crafting, one is used for your cosmetic hair work. And here is one of the another difference. Now if I need to dry up something, suppose this is a paint work I have taken. Now I have I'm using a black color cardstock, so that explaining you this becomes easier for me. You will be able to see the water clearly. Now here I have poured down the water. One side I'm going to use my heat gun, the other side I'm going to use my blow dryer. So I'll have my heat gun here, I'll have my blow dryer here, and I'm going to switch it on together. Now if you see this area, the blow dry area does not have any of the water in that area. Everything has splashed out. Now this is drying, this is slow drying, but I need to use my heat gun for a little more time. So this is actually going to do the exact drying work at the exact same area. It is not going to change and position of the color at all. So wherever you are going to keep your heat gun, it is going to dry. And always make sure that you evenly move your hair dryer from one area to another. And this is going to give you the exact color, design, shape, whatever you wanted for your artwork. And this is what exactly we look for when we are doing a mixed media project or a decoupage project. So can you see, if I run my blow dry here for some more time, and on this area it is going to dry out completely. So yes, for me these were the basic differences of a heat gun and a blow dryer. If you are a beginner and if you are not into embossing and you don't mind the color splashing, then hair dryer might work for you. But this is a one-time investment. I absolutely love this tool, and this is smaller in size, so this is very handy. This is very lightweight. I don't know about the other blow dryers, but The ones which I have been always using is this one, and there was one more from some other brand. They are very bulky, they are more heavier than this one. So yes, there is, honestly speaking, there should not be any comparison between a heat gun and a hair drying tool, because both of them have a complete different use, complete different utility. But many of you requested me, that's why I thought I should put up this tutorial for you guys. And yes, I'm putting up all the links down for these heat guns and the other options which is available in the market. You can check that, you should check that. And I hope I was able to answer all your queries. And still, if you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you all. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.